If you are a Lord of the Rings fan and want to talk about scenes within each film that mean a lot to you, let me know. In the extended edition reviews, I will be showcasing you and the love you have for these movies. You can talk about the extended scenes or regular theatrical editions. For further details, DM me on Twitter. The link to Twitter is in the description box. Welcome everyone to Cinema Spotlight. Diving into Peter Jackson's career, we will be talking about his second film, Meet the Feebles. Meet the Feebles is about a theater troupe hoping to be picked up for a syndicated television show. 12 hours until they're due to perform in front of a live audience, we watch as drama ensues throughout the entire day between scandals, Pride and Prejudice, and so much more. So... this movie, it's, let me take a moment here. I have to say right off the bat that this is a film I think appeals to a certain demographic. If you love raunchy humor, gross out humor in a perverse comic style directly intended to offend, if not gain praise to those who love bold and brash comedies, then I think this is a movie for you. This movie was not for me. In fact, I had a very hard time trying to get past through this film. But before I get into negatives, let's talk about the positives. On a technical level, this movie is actually more well-made than you may think. Between handheld puppets and actors wearing full body suits, this doesn't look poorly made. There are many close-ups of these puppets, and it makes everything feel and almost look very chaotic. But I'm pretty sure so much was thought into this film. The pre-visualization, the storyboards, I mean, I'm pretty sure a lot of it was well thought out well before the cameras were even rolling. Many of the puppets are doing something very raunchy or gross, and in the eyes of those can be very offended. You probably would want to keep your kids away from this one, I would say, big time. So if you've heard exactly what I've said here and went, you know what, that sounds like a movie for me, then God bless. I think you'll have a blast with this film. But, you know, with all that that can be seen as a positive thing, you almost can't believe that it's coming from this movie. It's just that kind of crazy. And I really just wasn't prepared for it. Now, I will tell you that I'm not completely against raunchy humor, but it depends on where it's coming from. It's just a higher level. You gotta be very, very, very keen and into this kind of humor. This was seriously not my film. I can look back on it and feel like there was a witty comment here or a clever thing there, and I can appreciate the hard work that went into this film, but I didn't like this film at all. And before I get into negatives, I have to tell you that there's probably a lot of people out there that do love this film. And by no means is this a jab at them for loving it and appreciating the execution over the material it conveys, but God, this was hard for me to get through. Here's why. Frickin' hell, there's just no story. There's no real story. Sure, there are actors and actresses trying to perform a stage play due to go live in 12 hours, making this the primary conflict, but we watch about four or five, maybe more, characters going through shit in these 12 hours. And that's, well, kind of, it shows you how desperately ugly all these personalities are. No one is really notable or relatable. They're watchable, but not relatable. A porcupine, who I would say is technically kind of like the audience member in all of this, he falls in love with a poodle and they are set to be married when they just met. The star of the show, a hippo, is in love with one of the producers, a walrus, who's screwing a cat. The walrus is emotionally and verbally dismissive and manipulative to the hippo, and it's kind of, it's just, it's not good. There's a rat that's in the porn industry and recruits the poodle to do an adult film, but the rat tries to take advantage of the poodle just as soon as the porcupine shows up, and I'm having a rough time with this one. there's a fly that loves to gossip and preys upon a rabbit who has a mysterious illness and tries to exploit him. Perhaps maybe with each storyline, there was something to comment on when it happens. And it really kind of comes in full circle towards the end. But it just, you can probably see things on a deeper level if you wanted to, where these actors and actresses in this trope allow their own pride and ambitions get in the way. And maybe that was the point to all of this. That's kind of what a satire is. I didn't hate this film, but I certainly didn't care for it either. For that, I disliked Meet the Feebles and probably wouldn't want to watch or own. However, I would like to know if you loved this film and tell me what you thought about it down below. I am not against anyone who ever seen this and actually ended up loving it. I'd love to know your perspective. That being said, thank you all so much for watching. If you've seen Meet the Feebles, let me know down in the comments. Be kind, be reasonable, and let's talk. Like, share, and subscribe, and click that bell so you don't miss another video. With all that said, I all hope you have a fantastic and wonderful day. Until next time.